Alright everybody, welcome back to Mass Effect Andromeda. We're just gonna talk to everybody in the crew. Get our relationship building going. Not to mention, I want to find out more about everybody.
Long time no chat. What's up? Seems like we have a good group here.
Well, Veteran Suvi are my girls. Get along well. Lots of mutual respect. PB's a real spark plug. I like her, but she's exhausting. And Drax's my kind of guy. Brash. Takes no shit. As far as your Hyperion peeps go, the Doc's kind of nosy. Liam's good for a laugh or two. Cora, she's a bit by the book for me.
We do need that. At least one person's got to be that way.
By the book keeps us alive.
Hey, variety's the spice of life, right? Different strokes makes for healthy debate.
What about Callow?
He's a pilot.
Which means...
he flies the ship.
We're leaving it at that, then?
Does a Pathfinder know what to do with a dead end?
Are you sure you can keep the Scourge damage under control?
Never seen anything like the Scourge. What it does to our tech. It's keeping me on my toes, but that's when I do my best work. In a way, I guess I'm grateful.
Well, you're welcome.
Don't do me any favors.
Don't worry, Ryder. You're in good hands.
Yeah, you know, I guess an engineer would love that sort of thing. You know, if you're just, okay, you know, I just got to tune the engine today. Nothing going on. But all of a sudden, there's a good problem to fix. Yeah. Yeah, I bet they love that.
What's your social circle like?
I'm good for a laugh, so I know lots of people. But I don't let too many in. My one true friend is stationed on the Nexus. She's the only piece of the Milky Way I brought with me. The more you and I get to know each other, the more you'll probably hear about her.
Oh, okay. Well, see, there we go.
How tough was it on the Nexus all those months?
Have you ever eaten overcooked space cow tongue?
You know, believe it or not, cow tongue is actually rather delicious. It tastes like roast beef, believe it or not. But no, I haven't had overcooked space cow tongue.
Can't say I have.
Well, let me tell you, it's tough. Wondering if you're gonna die from a critical malfunction, or maybe starvation. Imagining which would be worse. But hey, you could always take a break from the fear and boredom to dwell on being a part of the biggest failure in galactic history. Maybe even participate in a revolt.
What was your take on that?
I didn't place any bets, if that's what you're asking. Truth is, I don't think anyone made out particularly well. Whatever side you're on, you die a little when your brother, your teammate, becomes an enemy. Mm. We traveled all this way, all hope and wonder, and we end up fighting with each other over scraps. It's sad.
Yeah, it is.
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
Here's the one thing I'm wondering about the whole Andromeda Initiative and everything. So, before I get into that, I noticed this as I was, exiting the game last time, and that's pretty cool that they got that Ket base up here on the holoscreen. But what I was saying is, here's what I'm wondering about the whole Andromeda Initiative itself. Do they send a message to the Milky Way, like back, saying, "Hey, we made it"? And if they do, how long would it take for them for that message to get there? Very curious about that. Like, would it, you know, maybe 1,000 years later, and everybody's like, "Oh yeah, I forgot about those peeps." I don't know.
Feeling okay?
Oh, well, I guess there's not much more I can do with you.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Okay, the strike missions should be done from the last time I did them. Let's get an update on that. Yeah, failure. Figured those guys would fail. This guy, he's my dog. Okay, that's a silver. I need a good bronze. 70% chance of success. There we go. Gold. How about... ooh, 7% chance of success. Yeah, not gonna happen. He's got an 88% chance on that one. How about this one? Ugh. Okay, we'll send you on this Apex mission. Okay, now let's open our boxes. Ooh, thank you. I need uranium. And more credits. Thank you.
Strike team ready for deployment.
All right. Liam, my bro. What's up, man?
Pathfinder. Sorry, distracted. Feels like things should be on hold until the Molshai business is squared away. It's the neighborly thing to do, and we need good neighbors.
I won't be taking that route.
What's your read on the people we're working with?
The squad and crew? They're all fine.
You must have opinions.
Your opinion's more important. What do you think of your people?
Everyone has the training, but this job is all new every day.
That's probably what the Nexus is counting on. That our skills fit together to make it work. Up to us to figure it out. That's why this is our ship. So we own it. Want to make it work.
Just wondering what you think of how I'm doing at the job.
I'm committed to the initiative. You're Pathfinder. It's as simple as it gets.
That's not an answer. Like, I was asking for honest critique there, and you give me... I'm committed, and you're a Pathfinder. That tells me nothing, man.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
So, you've gained Ephra's trust. No easy feat.
Yeah, but at a price.
You mean the Rokar? Don't take it personally. They hate all aliens.
Ephra made it seem like you had experience with them.
I know their leader, Aksul. We studied together under the Molshai. But unlike me, he was a good student. The best, actually.
Then he knows about Remnant?
He did. It's a long story.
Give me the short version.
Aksul was captured by the Kett. He spent a year in a forced labor camp before he managed to escape.
Oh.
That's why he hates aliens.
Yes. He... suffered greatly. When Aksul returned, he no longer cared about the Remnant. Or anything. Except destroying the Kett.
Why not join the Resistance?
Aksul's not the type to follow orders. And... I think he was bitter we weren't able to rescue him.
So he formed the Rokar.
We didn't give them much thought. But since your people arrived... his cause has grown.
Here's one thing that's sort of bugging me. So, you notice, Jal's lip-synced in English. But if we're all speaking through a translator, technically... he shouldn't be lip-synced whenever he's speaking. He should be... his lips should be moving in some other strange way. Because technically he's speaking in his language and it's being translated into English. I don't know. Kind of weird to me.
I convinced Ephra I'm not a threat. Maybe I can do the same with Aksul.
I admire your courage. But Aksul's dangerous. And he lacks Ephra's pragmatism. He'll make you want to kill him.
I have to try.
If Helios is to be your home... I guess you'll have to deal with the Rokar one way or another. There's a recluse on Havarul who escaped with Aksul from the Kett. Her name is Tholdir. She might know how to contact him. I'll send you the nav point.
Oh, I didn't know I'd be picking up a mission here. Now, can we actually have, like, just a regular talk?
Aksul is very cunning. We can't underestimate him. My mothers are worried sick about the cousins that joined him.
Mothers?
I want to learn more about your species.
What would you like to know?
How long have you had electromagnetic capabilities? How do they evolve?
No idea. Biology doesn't interest me. But I'm sure you can easily read up on it.
That's disappointing. No biology at all?
How do your eyeballs work?
Okay, I get your point. Maybe I can find an Angara doctor to ask about your... whatever.
Although, I used to know some facts. Like the origins of our vestigial organs.
Oh yeah, humans have a coccyx, a vestigial tail. And I have webbed toes, just a couple, but Sarah doesn't. And she had wisdom teeth, but I didn't. Now you.
No idea.
The Angara seem so open and free with their feelings.
Are we? We're certainly not ashamed of our feelings. We're taught that feelings and beliefs should live on the outside, where they can be dealt with, honestly and openly.
Don't people get hurt?
Of course. Then everyone deals with it. That's the point.
Huh. That is an interesting sentiment. I don't think that would go over well in our daily lives. That would, yeah.
How many colonies do you have? On what planets?
Since the Scourge, we've managed to survive on a small number of planets. What we know from before the Scourge is mostly oral history. We did have spaceflight, and the stories tell of 5 original colonies.
5 original colonies. I wonder if that's telling of this game, because from what I'm seeing, we're supposed to end up with 5 colonies. Huh.
You studied with Mos Eisefa. Is she a teacher or a religious figure?
She's many things. She's a clear thinker with deep knowledge and insight. She teaches and inspires. She is beloved. I love her.
Really? So one of those professor-student things?
No, not that way. Mos Eisefa is 115 of your years old.
Actually, that's interesting to know. Like, how long do the Angara live? Like, Asari live for centuries. Krogan live for... Well, actually, Asari live for a millennia or more. The Angarans, I'm not sure. And the Krogan, the same thing, millennia or more.
Is there a central Angaran religion?
There are many variations. An almanac could give you an accurate number. But if you are a believer, the essential tenet is, after we die, we are reincarnated. We evolve to make our families strong. Born from what was before. Blessed to be better than before.
Are you a believer?
No. Yes. Sometimes. I don't know if it's the same for humans. Sahuna, my true mother, is a firm believer.
See, I hope he gets more into this mother's thing and my true mother. I'm very curious about that.
Well, enough about that. What's your story, Jal? Tell me about yourself.
Why?
Well, why wouldn't you? You hiding something?
Maybe. That would only make sense.
You're messing with me, right?
Possibly. What does it mean?
It's an idiom. It means you're joking, trying to make me feel uncomfortable.
Ah, then no. Ephra instructed me to be cautious. I'm not very good at being cautious.
Can you tell me more about the Ked occupation?
It's a difficult subject. I'll answer what I can. I may get emotional.
Hmm.
What's living under the Ket bin like for you?
Do you really want to hear about these things? They're painful.
I asked, didn't I?
It's like living on unstable ground. Every day brings more horrible news. I part company with someone, not knowing if I'll ever see them again. When I was a boy, my father vanished from my life. One horrible day.
Was he in the Resistance?
No. He was a technician at a mine. He went to work and didn't come home. That happens for an Angara child somewhere, every single day.
That is pretty freaking horrible.
When the Ket came, why didn't you fight?
They didn't give us a reason to. Until they did. Then it was too late. Perhaps you think we were weak. But the Ket are ruthless. They are masters at knowing exactly when and how to strike.
I get that. Believe me. Have the Ket always been here?
No. Some, like the Morshai, are old enough to remember the time before the Ket. But I don't. Nor do my mothers.
And the Archon came with them?
We think so. Resistance intel on that is unclear, and few have seen him in person.
And lived to tell?
And lived to tell.
Well, enough about that.
Aw, man. Where'd all the other options go?
I want to learn more about your species.
What would you like to know?
No.
Well, enough about that.
Well, that sucks.
I'll see you later, Jarl.
Stay strong and clear.
I noticed some of my options go away after a little while. I wonder why.
I never get out
really
the
like
with you guys.
I really like that, finding that information.
Did you hear the news from Eos? Asari refugees showed up at the outpost.
Oh.
Only a few, but that's better than none. Bradley says there's an officer in charge, Hidaria. She could know where the Ark is.
We'll head to Eos and see what she knows.
Good. Rumor says Sarissa Theris was on the Asari Ark. Exactly who we need.
Theris.
Who's she?
Probably the best commando strategist alive. Her biotic shields saved hundreds at the Battle of Kirkus. Apparently, Sarissa's acting as bodyguard to the Asari Pathfinder. She's probably got a plan out of this mess already.
Well, someone's a fan.
No, I just like... Look, we need someone with her experience, that's all.
I'll take someone with that much experience. Another reason to find the Ark.
When you're ready to look, we can catch Hidaria at Prodromos. Wouldn't mind tagging along.
Hmm. Read email from... Oh, well. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter if we so-called fail a step. It looks like we just kind of skipped a step. Oh, wait. That is not where I wanted to head. I wanted to head back here. Looks like we won't need to go in the engine room because the engineer's right here. But we still need to find everybody else. Oh, there's PB again.
Yep.
Aya is a wonder rider, and the Angara are so interesting. I hope we make it back. I want to delve and explore and who knows what else.
We'll be back. We need the Moshai if we're to get into their vault.
Oh, I'm definitely sticking around long enough for that.
Flirting.
I like it when you flirt. I wouldn't want you to stop.
Have I flirted with you? Don't worry, Ryder. I'm relentless. It relaxes me.
Thanks for chatting. We'll talk again later.
You know it.
Some of these flirts are so lame. You know what? I need to go speak to Cora again. Actually talk to her. Like I did with Jarl. The med bay. The doctor's upstairs, so she won't be in here, but I haven't seen...
Now, there was a time when Sid was afraid of space. We were traveling a lot, and one day she just woke up and realized there was nothing outside the shuttle walls. Happened more than once. She'd panic. I'd hold her for as long as it took. She doesn't even remember now. It was only for a month or two.
Funny, huh? The things they don't remember.
And you feel like it's up to you to hold on to it. Or else it's just gone.
And there's just something there that you know you're missing.
Drac?
Just hold on to it.
So as of right now, it looks like we've got a lead on, well, kind of, on the Turian Ark, because they said Turians were on the previous planet. And looks like the Asaris, we may get info on them on Eos.
That is a nice little piece of paradise the Angara have. Wouldn't mind seeing it again.
I wouldn't mind either. Maybe we can have something like that too someday.
We rescue that Moshi of theirs. Maybe they'll give us some tips.
Well, bummer. I was hoping...
We can talk more later.
Sure.
I was hoping to get more out of some of these guys, but it looks like I'm very, very limited.
What can I do for you, Pathfinder?
Shit.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Okay, what's in here? Wardrobe. Oh yeah, that's just my casual outfit. One thing we can do is check emails and talk to Sam.
Hello, Ryder.
What's the latest on memory triggers?
A memory has unlocked and is available for further investigation. You will need to return to Soundnode in the Hyperion.
Oh, okay.
Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
So, yeah, we need to go back to the Hyperion, and we also need to go to Eos, and we'll come back to this planet. It appears, what the hell is that model there? Wish there was a way to zoom in. All right. Wow, a lot of emails. Turians on Harval. Yeah, here we are. This is exactly what I was talking about, Pathfinder, of getting reports about Turian sightings on Harval. Since it's an Angaran world, I was hoping you could check it out. Apex isn't noted for their diplomatic talents. This needs discretion, Kandros. Okay. Take that mission. Making contacts. Let me archive that. From Liam, heads up. First thing I did for Aya, figure out who to really talk to, because we all know the ones in charge, they're not on the ground. Jal had some pointers, and I got the names of some smaller Angaran colonies. It'll be a while before they trust us, but it's all about exposure. Saw it all the time in crisis response, especially post-combat zones. Low Consul Varand, if you see any messages from her, it's just me reaching out, Costa. Liam has included a list of media-themed first contact. Genres include hard science fiction and a sorry vid about first contact with humanity titled How They Must See Us. Balanced Diet from Lexi. As part of overseeing the crew's physical and mental welfare, I thought I'd send along the following tips for a balanced diet. Given that large amounts of exercise you partake in each day, it's important that your body receives the nutrients it needs. Carbohydrates, 5 to 11 servings a day. Holy shit. Fruits and veggies, 4 to 5 servings a day. Proteins, 3 servings a day. Fats, 1 serving or less a day. No, I want my fat. I've heard privately from Evra, the leader of the Resistance. He's very impressed that we were able to help Op Squad on Vyald, and I've made sure that he knows that you played a key role. Maybe he's already said these things to you, but if I know Evra, he probably hasn't. As for me, I've learned a lot about trust. Being on this team, letting myself be open to trusting you and others, I've learned that trust is more of a feeling than a science, and it seems like it is a universal truth. Universal. Get it? Haha. I'll try to be even more trustful in the future. This assignment might change my life. Good night, Jal. Oh, that's interesting. Writings of... I'm not big into... this is just like a list of writings to read. Confidential Vyald intel. Since your liberation of the labor camp on Vyald, some information has come to my attention. For years, the Ket ignored our work in the frozen city of Jal Nick, searching for details of our buried past didn't seem to threaten them. One day, we must have uncovered something that the Ket deemed extremely dangerous. They invaded the city, killing or enslaving our archaeological teams, and locked it down. Intel from the labor camp seems to confirm what have, to this point, only been crazy rumors. There may be ancient pre-scourge AI locked in the ice in the depths of the city. Oh. This explains the prefix's swift and violent move. I've heard that the Ket shun tech like artificial intelligence, and they certainly wouldn't want us to have it. Please keep this knowledge to yourself. Oh. Okay, so... if that's the case, they are not going to be too happy about Sam. I don't think they've figured out that Sam is the reason... we've been able to access the tech. Shit, where did Cora go? Damn it. Cora, where did you go? Cora, F it. Alright. Yeah, PB's not in there. We've checked our emails. Alright, let's have a chat with Suvi.
The discovery of Aya was just what we needed, Ryder. The Angaran scientists have been so generous in sharing their wisdom. It's been amazing.
Angaran expertise will be a tremendous help to the initiative.
We were certainly hurting for it. I'm thankful the Angara were willing to risk working with us.
I'm afraid not all of them are quite so friendly.
Some give trust easily. From others, you have to earn it. I'm confident we'll get there.
I should get back to things.
Sounds good.
I was hoping for more dialogue options, but it looks like we're just kind of having basic conversations right now.
Hello, Gil. When are you cleaning up that repair on the sensor console?
I'm not. It's a redesign.
A redesign? Without a trained crew?
I'm trained and it's working great. Don't be so uptight.
Everything okay?
Oh, fine. Fine. Don't worry about it.
So that's why Gil's kind of like, he's our pilot. Okay, let's, I think we're going to head back to the Nexus.
Not really a holiday destination.
Yeah, I know we've got plenty of stuff to turn. Look at all this stuff we have to do. God. So much stuff. And we might just check out some of these other spots that don't exactly have a mission on them. But let's head to the Nexus first. I wonder when we get our sister, Sarah, out of cryo. I wonder when that happens. Sorry about that. Bump the mic. I wonder why we took an arcing path. I wonder if the gravitational forces caused that, or... Love how it looks almost exactly like the Citadel, like it was, and they've pretty much made it clear that the Citadel was kind of the model for this. Okay, we don't want to do that. We're gonna
watch your tone. You saw what happened to Krogan.
But we need this equipment.
Well, you're not getting it. Stop making frivolous requests.
It's not a frivolous request. Properly functioning air filters are
frivolous. You'll just have to make do.
We can't fix the station breathing bad air.
Your incompetence isn't my problem. Just do your job.
What do you want?
Sounds like you're having a rough day.
You saw that, huh? Oh, I'm sorry I snapped at you. The way Spender treats me? Everyone, I'm so angry. I don't understand how he's in any position of authority.
He was pretty abusive towards you. Is that normal?
Yes, he's horrible. Working with him is a total nightmare. Just last week, he tried to redirect some of the supplies we need to keep the stasis pods going.
Why?
I have no idea. But if Kesh hadn't stepped in and threatened to airlock him, it would have been a disaster. He's always like that. Making bad decisions, driving the Krogan away, treating people like scum when no one's watching.
Maybe there's something I can do?
A man like that's bound to have some dirt. I wish Tan and Addison could see it. Things have gotten so bad that Kesh had to literally kick him out of engineering.
How literal are we talking here?
Boot to ass. Oh, it was glorious. We need him gone, but as incompetent as Spender is at his job, he's insanely good at keeping it. Kesh can tell you more.
Huh. All right. All right, what do we got? We don't really need to hit any stores right now. We can, but hydroponics, we don't need to hit that. Oh, game of poker. We can do that. Yeah, we can go play game of poker.
Wait, people are doing what?
Protesters?
I don't know. If someone doesn't get 3-0, I'll be eating shoe leather by the end of the week.
Hang on. What protesters?
So how things go?
Tell our leader.
Seems quiet for now. Look, Jonesy.
I know. This isn't my sound up for either.
Or make them go!
What the hell?
Clan before Chrome.
Hey, what's going on?
That's your new galaxy. Making speeches about some fresh start while your kids stay frozen.
And it's all thanks to your Pathfinder.
Excuse me?
We've waited months for our families to come out of stasis. They should have gone to your outpost.
But since you think research is so important, military personnel got bumped down the list, like my clan brothers.
All the reassignments mean they're in 10 different colony blocks now.
And my mother just got caught in the middle.
I founded the outpost. I didn't decide who would stay in stasis.
You don't care that you've torn families apart?
That's not what I said.
Maybe you could still make this right. I just want Mom out of stasis. That's all anyone here wants.
You do stasis revivals. You can tell our leaders you're opening those pods. Today.
I authorize whole colony blocks or a few emergency revivals. I can't wake dozens of random people.
We don't care whose finger pushes the button. If you can't, our leaders can. And if you tell them, they will.
I don't know what to do here. They're kind of being very irrational. Like, they knew what they signed up for.
Okay. I'll talk to the leadership about what we can do.
14 months of promises. It's time for some results.
We tried petitioning Addison. She ignored us. Screw her!
Start with Kandros. He set those 10 soldiers over there. Maybe he'll take us seriously.
And before Chrome.
Okay, let's go to Vortex. Play some poker with Gil. Can I dance now? I want crappy dancing. Just twerking it.
So, Ryder, big news. I think I found my purpose in life.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
Thrashing you at poker? Shall I deal?
Ryder, I can read Gil's vital signs and give you an advantage during the game if you like.
Ah, man, I kind of want to do it, but no.
Don't. All right? You can deal first. Having fun?
Getting my ass kicked is what I'm doing.
Poker's lost me several friends over the years. The only one who still plays me is my buddy Jill. I know. Jill and Gil.
Is Jill a masochist?
She must be a glutton for punishment.
That's her. That's how I know she'll always be there. Jill's a fatality expert. Heads the initiative CRC. My only real friend from back home. I bet 50.
I call. The CRC?
Colonial Repopulation Committee. She's always teasing that I'm making her job harder. Says if I'm not making babies, I'm part of the problem. We have that kind of relationship.
Well, she's not wrong.
Growing our numbers is paramount to our survival here.
Sure, but that's Jill's purpose. I'm not just going to adopt it. See what I did there? I'm not just going to adopt it.
I saw.
You should meet her. You'll see. She's amazing. Another 100.
I fooled.
Another one for me, then.
Well, that's that. You win.
I've achieved my true purpose in life. What will I do now?
Revenge will be mine.
Someday, maybe.
Jill predicted you'd be my downfall. Can't wait to tell her she was wrong. Another streak intact, I'll say.
Ouch. Have fun. And thanks for the game.
I'll use Sam next time. If there is one.
Hello?
Welcome to the Vortex.
Another one! Damn it! This is supposed to be the chemistry lab. My chemistry lab. You all keep crawling out of the woodwork like space cockroaches.
What? You say that, Dutch, but here you are, pouring people drinks.
Hi. I'm standing right here.
They're guinea pigs, damn it. Chemists should have guinea pigs. Not have their labs taken over by people giving them things and
being nice.
I am lost right now. What the hell is he talking about? He's in a bar. Yes, gifts. Horrible things, those.
Bad people. Giving you free things and helping you set up. So inconsiderate.
Right? They keep bringing things. Tables and chairs and this bar and lights.
Wait, you're making fun of me, aren't you?
Don't let Dutch put you off. He's a sweetie, really.
I'm not.
And the drinks are good.
Damn right they are. I mean... Yeah. Have a dirty squirrel.
A dirty squirrel? I do have squirrel fur on my face, so... I love all these little side stories. I like the context that they're giving you. Okay... I don't see anything else on the map. Looks like we can probably go ahead and head to the shuttle. Or, well, the tram, I guess. Now, I can head to, where is that? Ops, Habitation, Cryo. We'll probably hit all three before we leave, but we'll head to Ops first. I know we've got a few missions to turn in. Yeah, we'll speak with Kandros in a minute. We're just gonna kind of make the rounds.
I hear you went down to Eos. Did you find anything to help my case?
You're a liar. The Chief's Omnitool recorded you over the body admitting to killing him.
What? Wait, that's not... What are you trying to pull?
Sam, playback.
Sorry, old friend. Had to do it. I'm not dying on this rock. Well, shit. Guess my fate is sealed.
Except that your shot missed. A Ket blast to the back killed Reynolds.
Are you serious? I'm innocent? What a stroke of luck.
Actually, that's called
a... conviction will have to be overturned. The sentence thrown out.
No, it's called attempted murder, you jackass.
I'm going to Tan, and I might have a different opinion. You did try to cover it all up.
Look, I'm sorry I lied, but if my shot missed, I'm innocent, plain and simple.
We'll see about that.
I don't know, man. That's attempted murder, and... That's not innocence. That just means you're a shitty shot. Damage control. I think I've seen all of these. Yeah.
Pathfinder. Wow. I'm Davis Carr, Helios News Service. Maybe you've heard my voice over the vids.
Nope.
I'm trying to file a story right now, but hey.
HNS, huh? Where are the rest of you?
I had an editor, but it's crazy out here. Now, beyond a freelancer or two, I'm it. All that stands between freedom and tyranny, or something. I haven't had much sleep.
Who pays for you to do this?
Technically, H&S is an arm of the Initiative, but we serve the public, not them. Sometimes the higher-ups try and tell us what to broadcast, Tan especially, but we decide what to run and how to run it. It causes friction, but at least I can live with myself.
Were you a journalist back in the Milky Way?
I was. Sort of. Only had a couple internships under my belt. Good places, though. The New Star Chronicle even sent me to Mars for a week. The plan was just to work as a reporter out here. Then the uprising happened. We got a little too close. My editor was killed. Tan blamed our broadcasts for stirring unrest. It was bullshit. Now all I want to do is keep going.
Tan is one shitty administrator.
It must be difficult to set up a broadcast from scratch.
No, it's easy. Beyond the lack of staff, resistant authorities, and constant technical glitches. Still, I'm getting there. May have an honest-to-goodness source in Nexus Security, if she ever calls me back.
Who's your source?
No journalist worth their salt will ever give that up.
Well, he's got a point.
I met another journalist, Kerry Tavessa.
Yeah, we're running Kerry's series. Path of a Hero. Good stuff. I'm mostly on my own, so pretty much anyone who brings me news is welcome. Content is king, and her content is really touching a nerve.
Talk to you later, Davis.
Hey, Ryder, before you go, I hate to ask, but it seems like your job takes you all over, the places we can't broadcast yet. If I send receivers to your ship, would you mind placing them on some planets? It'll help get news out to even the most far-flung colonists.
I'm okay with that.
What do you need from me, exactly?
I'm digging up good stories here, but not a lot of people beyond the Nexus can hear them. Our long-distance transmitter sends package data between ships, and even planet-side, provided there's a receiver on the other end. I need someone to place receivers and boost our signal. We only have a few, so they need to go on planets with people.
Okay, Davis. I'll help you get set up.
Great. Just place a receiver near an outpost, and they'll get our reports.
Okay, I can place one at Prodomos.
Maintenance crews, please report to the commons area.
Probably smuggling trouble again. I love being able to explore all this stuff. God.
Apex team leaders reporting back.
I love it. All right, Lieutenant Sajax.
Push back.
Hey, Ryder, I'd like a moment.
Yes, Lieutenant Sajax, right?
Oh, Sajax.
That's me. I'm putting together Apex strike teams to protect the people and assets you're setting up out there. We don't have a good sense of what we're up against and could benefit from your experience.
I'll have Sam upload our insights on the Ket, Remnant, and Outlaw forces we've encountered.
Thanks. You'll see. Apex will make a difference.
Wonder if that did anything for me. Well, we don't need to set up any strike team missions right now.
No news on the Turian Arc yet? Or is this militia business?
I need to talk to you about Stasis Revival and those protesters in hydroponics.
I see. Maybe I should get the others for this.
Protesters have seized hydroponics?
They want their families out of Stasis. The outpost on Eos disrupted the schedule. They're scattered across colony blocks, dozens of people. The protesters want this fixed today.
The realities of our position are...
We can't wake those families. We don't have the resources, and there's nowhere to put them.
I mean, they're right. I mean, until I get another colony up, like, where do you put them? I mean, we do have a whole planet, but... If... No. I think they're right.
We only just got on our feet. Plus, it messes up the schedule again. What do you suggest?
Leave the families in Stasis where it's safe and get those protesters out of hydroponics. They seem sympathetic, but so did the exiles. We can't risk another revolt. Survival is more important than family reunions.
What would you do with the protesters?
I'd send in a squad and march them out. At gunpoint, if we must.
Mm.
If they resist, a few might land in medbay, but it's better than losing hydroponics or the Nexus.
Do you think these protests could turn violent?
We're all pioneers. Even civilians are tough enough to start something.
And interfering in hydroponics threatens our oxygen supply. They know that.
Yeah, I mean, the way this is set up, I mean, yeah, sure you want to see your families, but so does everybody else. I mean, what gives you the right to protest? It's like, you know what you signed up for. You knew the consequences. This is probably going to bite me in the ass.
We have to look at the bigger picture. Get them out of there.
Kandros?
I'll send in a team, but it might go smoother if Ryder's there.
A good idea. Sometimes we have to give bad news. That's a Pathfinder's duty, too.
All right. That kind of sucks, but...
Tracking enemy activity. Reports out to intelligence.
Thanks for understanding about the outpost and the protesters.
You don't strike me as the political type.
I'm not. Just pro keeping everyone alive. Maybe those protesters will eventually understand, too. It's done. I don't want to think about it. Need something else?
Oh, okay.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
Thought there was more
to it. You and me both, Pathfinder.
All right. Let's go up, talk to others.
As sleepers wake from sleep.
Okay, let's give Draka. Wait, data pad. For posterity, in case the initiative goes belly up, the Nexus is a four-ring circus. Don't like how Tan operates, and his disdain for the Krogan is obvious. I believe his intentions are ultimately good, but he's an opportunity who's likely to create dissent. I don't see the Nexus coming together if he's left unchecked. It's already polarizing Addison. Oh, wait a minute. I think I've already read that one, but let's have a... Can I talk to Drak?
He's not getting out of lockup for a while.
There we go.
Did you tell him I was
Ryder, can you believe this place?
One space station, slightly dented?
You should have seen it a year ago. It was more than just dented. Anyway, thanks for bringing me on. Tan can't kick me off the station now, and it's been nice seeing my granddaughter again.
You really did miss her while you were gone, huh?
I really did. Cash can handle herself just fine, but it's still good to be nearby, just in case.
Okay.
What? How can we be out of those materials?
I don't know. Ben's looking into it. Don't worry. Probably just another computer glitch.
Vetra never had these glitches.
That's because Vetra kept it all in her head. We mere mortals aren't as good at that.
Del told me you saw her arguing with Spender. Pyjak's doing his best to throttle my department. How's he getting away with that? Spender doesn't know the first thing about engineering, but he knows how to play people. More importantly, he still talks to the exiles. I'm sure of it. I just can't prove it without your help. This needs to be investigated. I'm glad someone thinks so. Talk to Kandros. He likely has security footage, some kind of evidence. But you'll have to convince him to authorize release.
Okay, well, I'll talk to Kandros.
Nothing more for now. Later.
But after I talk to everybody up here, go to Director Tan again eventually. After I'm done up here with Addison.
The mutiny went as well as you'd expect. So much violence. Then, after nearly destroying the station, the Krogan asked for more power?
Yes, Pathfinder.
Good riddance.
How the hell should I know?
Why'd you join the initiative?
You have a job.
I was a teacher. A good life. I could see the positives and negatives right through to the end.
You did the math, and it said, come to Andromeda?
No. I just didn't like being able to see the end. Here, I don't have a clue what tomorrow will bring. Feels more like living.
What? Whoa. Okay.
Maintenance crews, please report to the commons area.
Yes, Pathfinder?
How are we doing on the viability front?
Struggling. Need I remind you that viability isn't abstract. It's lives, our foothold. Get out there, Ryder. Pathfind, we're dying.
I have info on a specific sleeper I'd like brought out of cryo.
I want to avoid that entirely. For reasons.
Reasons? That's it?
Look, you're the Pathfinder. If you've a request for your extended team, that's a request you can make. Access the sleeper records through Brekker's console. It's none of my business. Until you make it a problem for me. Understood?
Well, why are these conversations ending?
What's the deal with your assistant? He's a bit...
Spender is an ass.
That's one way of putting it.
I'm aware that he holds certain prejudices, but so does Tan. And we've limited personnel to draw from. Get us more outposts, maybe that changes.
Having people like him around doesn't do your department any favors.
Personality problems are pretty far down my give-a-shit list.
How has the Nexus reacted to the foothold I've established?
We send them where you signal, because that's where the need is. There's no time for preference.
Director Addison?
Goodbye, Pathfinder.
Sorry, she's such a bitch! Okay, well, is this the console? Is this the specific waking up that people are talking about?
How may I assist?
I have a specific person I want brought out of cryo.
Name and designation if available.
That's it? You'll just do it?
Nowhere in my job description does it say, argue with the Pathfinder. That said, I record all interactions. If something you ask for causes trouble, there'll be no doubt that you're responsible.
EOS Chief Engineer Grace Leto.
I heard that the Chief Engineer on EOS went back into cryo.
There have been a few such requests. The first few months in Helios were disheartening.
Now that Prodromos is on track, I want her redeployed.
Chief Engineer Grace Leto, designation E97 Durango. Deployment will begin shortly. Is there anything else, Pathfinder?
Oh.
I have a specific person I want brought out of cryo.
Name and designation if available.
Let's keep this between us. Here's the info.
Deployment will begin shortly. Is there anything else?
I don't remember what that one was for, but...
Why do some colonists have a number letter designation?
All initiative members do. In a CV file somewhere, anyway. It isn't relevant when everyone is doing everything. I suppose it's like... caring about a middle name. Do you not know yours?
No, I don't.
I wasn't aware I had one.
You were in select company, even before you were made Pathfinder. Rider Pathfinder, specialist designation A04 Malapa.
Something interesting?
An A and low odds. Someone's an early adopter.
What's your take on the state of the initiative?
Please consult the AVP interface. It has a thorough breakdown of your progress.
And your personal opinion?
Your progress thrills me. Make my job obsolete, Pathfinder. I dare you.
This guy's kind of interesting.
Another time.
Pathfinder.
Talk to Addison. And redeploy Leto. Okay, so I just... Woohoo!
Superintendent Cash reminds everyone, all power grid...
I am gonna have to go back to Prodromos. Eventually. Well, actually, it'll be soon after this, I think. I didn't think we'd have to go back as often. That's pretty awesome, actually. We'll go talk to Tan. I've got to remember to do this more often.
Well, old man, we're getting there. Put in a good word for us.
Cora.
Whole mood of the Nexus has changed since EOS. You really can feel it. New outpost, a Pathfinder's help, people waking up. It's a fresh start.
Can't relax yet. The initiative still has a lot of promises to keep.
And that's on us. But it's damn good to know we're on the right track.
Okay. We've read that data pad.
No, I am not.
Congratulations are in order. Peaceful contact with the Angara. It's everything the initiative stands for.
It was amazing. A culture we'd never met before, in a brand new galaxy. I was just glad to be part of it.
It's a moment to savor. In the Milky Way, first contact was a rare event. In the meantime, I am eager to forge diplomatic ties with the Angaran people. We need any allies we can get. Did you have some other business?
Director, I checked out that murder. Nilkin didn't do it, but there's proof that he meant to.
This is unfortunate. We're trying to give the people a sense of stability, leadership they think they can count on. And we're setting precedent for justice here in Andromeda. Now this, a convicted murderer who didn't commit the murder.
These things are almost never black and white.
I know. If we suppress the evidence and uphold the conviction, we're banishing a man for a crime he technically didn't commit. If we throw the conviction out, we're freeing a man who tried to take matters into his own hands, then covered it up. Your investigation complicated this. You should take responsibility for the outcome. Do we still exile him for murder?
He's right, but... Well, okay, so they tried him on murder, so technically it is a mistrial. And we can't exile him. Because we did convict him of a murder he didn't commit. It wasn't attempted murder we convicted him on. Yeah.
It was crazy down there. Life and death. But his shot didn't kill Reynolds. We have to let him go.
You're a bottom line type of person. I hope we don't regret it.
Me too.
All right, so be it. He will do community service for his role in the chaos. But he's a free man.
Okay, that's fair.
At least we'll have this sordid business behind us.
Woohoo! More skill points. I wonder what the max level is. Because I am level 14 now. I have 5 combat points. I'll have to upgrade the entire crew when I'm ready. Before we get into battle next time. Okay, we need to go talk to Kandros yet again.
No news on the Turian Ark yet? Or is this militia business?
I was told I should talk to you about the mutiny.
I wasn't on the Nexus when it happened. I started reading up on it, but you know how things get around here.
Do you know where Spender was during that time?
Why Spender? Wait, you think he might have had something to do with the mutiny?
Maybe. Just trying to sort things out.
You know, the logs I did look through showed a few discrepancies. I meant to dig deeper. If you're investigating, how about I give you access to the security vid archives?
Thank you.
Anything else?
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Okay, let's go to the videos. Those were over here, I think.
Apex personnel, please check your duty roster for important.
This file won't play. Sam, can you boost the quality?
Processing. Playback initiated.
Wait, is he handing something over to one of the mutineers?
Take this. It'll help you. Don't.
I am sorry, Pathfinder. This backup file is corrupted. The audio tracks are heavily degraded. Someone may have deleted the original, and this version was restored during a system-wide reset.
Sounds like a cover-up to me.
I concur. While I cannot restore any more audio, the location appears to be Kadara.
How do you figure?
In common parlance, lip reading. I do not recognize the location from any current data. It appears mountainous and populated. We will need to find the planet before I can confirm. I will contact you via my node.
Oh.
Let's go confront him.
Wonder where he's at. Oh, okay. We probably have to go back to the main concourse to confront him, and we're going to do that on the way out. Yeah, the docking bay. We're not going to do that. We're going to go to the Hyperion.
Species are at odds as talks break down over a unified curriculum for initiative kids. The Asari say they'll wait it out until demands are met. This is HNS.
All right, I think we're going to end things here. When we come back, we're going to go through the Hyperion, see what we can do, and then we'll head back to that docking bay, of course, take care of the protesters and question that guy. And then we'll head down to the Eos, to the colony, Prodomos. All right, everybody. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.